Hello all, this is Brian McCrae with the North Carolina Wildlife Resource Commission. It is the middle of the summer and unfortunately striped bass are dying at Lake Norman. The purpose of this video is to explain what is causing these fish kills that routinely occur at Lake Norman during this time of year. Every summer, Lake Norman stratifies into three distinct layers of water: a top layer, a middle layer, and a bottom layer. The top layer consists of hot water, high oxygen levels, and forage fish that striped bass utilize for food. As the summer progresses, the middle layer essentially consists of cool water, no oxygen, and little food. During the first half of the summer, the bottom layer consists of cold water, high oxygen levels, and since about the year 2000, a specific kind of forage fish called river herring. Unfortunately, river herring should not be in Lake Norman, but were introduced during an unauthorized stocking event. Because of that unauthorized stocking event and the presence of river herring, striped bass have an incentive to congregate in the bottom layer. If river herring were not in Lake Norman, striped bass would likely stay in the top layer where the food resources are, even though the water temperatures would be higher than their preferred range. The problem with striped bass congregating in the bottom layer is that it also loses oxygen as the summer progresses. The fish are essentially trapped in a bubble that has a limited amount of oxygen and continues to shrink. Therefore, as the oxygen bubble gets smaller, striped bass die because of the lack of oxygen. Eventually, all of the oxygen is gone from the bottom layer, and most of the striped bass that were trapped in the bottom layer die. This is the fourth year in a row where a summer kill resulting from these environmental conditions has occurred. Because the reservoir stratifies into three layers every year, we speculate that the severity of the stratification differs among years. For example, there is a time during the summer when the middle layer is thinner in some years as compared to others. And we hypothesize that during those years, striped bass can migrate from the bottom layer into the top layer as the oxygen bubble shrinks in the bottom layer. However, the middle layer has been very thick the past 4 years, and it acts as a lid that prevents striped bass from migrating to the top layer. As a result, the striped bass become trapped in the bottom layer and die from oxygen deprivation. Future research is needed to better understand what causes the middle layer to be thick in some years but thin in others. Nevertheless, we are evaluating our management strategy for striped bass at Lake Norman, where our goal is to produce a quality fishery that is popular, that can be sustained with available resources, and that does not cause unnecessary harm to the natural environment.